Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Media here. Today we're going to be talking about performance modifications and upgrades for Ford's 6.7 PowerStroke turbo diesel engine. The 6.7 PowerStroke has been around since 2011 and it has three different generations. So first let's go ahead and talk a little bit about the differences in these generations, and then I'm going to go ahead and follow that up with discussing the various different power limits of each of these generations before getting into the actual modifications on our list here. So the first gen was from 2011 to 2014. The first gen is generally considered the less reliable engine, but also from a performance standpoint, it is the least capable. And that's because it came with the weakest injection pump and it came with the smallest turbocharger. For the second gen from 2015 to 2019, we did get a slightly stronger injection pump and we got a larger turbocharger. So the Gen 2s are gonna be a bit more capable than the Gen 1s. And then moving into Gen 3 from 2020 plus, the Gen 3's got a brand new injection system. However, it still uses the same CP4.2 injection pump as the Gen 2s. And so the injection pump has the same limitations as it does on the Gen 2s. And the turbocharger on the Gen 3s is very similar to the turbocharger on the Gen 2s. So for the most part, the Gen 3s are gonna be slightly more capable than the Gen 2s, but they should be right around the same ballpark from a power capacity standpoint. So with that being said, let's go ahead and talk about the power limits of each of these different generations. The Gen 1s are limited to about 475 to 500 wheel horsepower on the stock turbocharger. So once you start pushing up against these power levels, you're going to need to upgrade the turbocharger. And at that point, if you want to start pushing beyond that, you're also going to need to upgrade the injection pump because that's about the limit of the injection pump as well. On the Gen 2s, the turbo caps out around 550 wheel horsepower. The injection pump is a little bit stronger and can handle a little bit closer to about 600 wheel horsepower. However, if you're going to go ahead and upgrade the turbocharger, that's going to be the right time to upgrade the injection pump as well. And one of the common routes here is to add a secondary injection pump. It's common to run a CP3 with the CP4.2 or to do a complete conversion to get rid of the CP4.2 since they are known to be problematic injection pumps in the first place. And then the Gen 3, like I mentioned, has a little bit more capability than the Gen 2 does, but you're going to run into the limitation right around the same power levels for the turbocharger. And as I mentioned, it's the same injection pump, so you're going to be capped around that 600 wheel horsepower level on the Gen 3s also. And then just generally speaking, for all of the 6.7 PowerStrokes from 2011 to present, 700 wheel horsepower is considered about the safe maximum limit for these engines before you start running into the possibility of bending rods. So the good news on all these engines, really to get it up to that 700 wheel horsepower level, the only thing that you need to do is upgrade the turbocharger and upgrade the injection pump, because the injectors that are used on all of these engines are very strong and capable of handling 700 plus wheel horsepower. So ultimately getting to the maximum limit of these engines isn't very difficult to do. It just requires a turbocharger and an injection pump. And then that brings us to the transmission. The 2011 to 2019 models that use the 6R140 are good until about 650 wheel horsepower. So that's actually very good power capacity out of these transmissions. However, the 2020 plus models got the 10R140. And because these 2020 plus models come with so much torque from the factory, over 1,000 wheel torque, the transmissions are going to be a lot more limited on these 2020 plus models. So even if you do something just as simple as adding tuning to the 2020 pluses, you'll want to make sure you work with a tuner who understands the limitations of these 10-speed transmissions. So guys, at the end of the day, we've got basic bolt-on modifications, and honestly, tuning alone can take you to the maximum power limits of each of these generations. And so unless you're looking at getting into expensive turbocharger upgrades and expensive injection pump upgrades, the best thing you can do here is throw some basic bolt-on modifications on it and be happy with those power levels. Otherwise, you're probably looking at 5, 7, or 10 grand to go ahead and get yourself up to that 700 wheel horsepower level, at which point you do run the risk of bending rods. So doing a full build to go beyond those power levels gets quite a bit more expensive and complex. So that brings us to our list of modifications here. Tuning is the number one thing. Tuning can take all of these engines right up to the stock turbo power limits. So you might think, oh, let's just slap a tune on it and go ahead and max these engines out. However, it's important to try to maximize the efficiency of these engines because the more efficient the engine is, the less heat it will produce, and so the lower engine temps and EGTs we'll have, and therefore the more reliable of an engine we have. So yes, you can just throw a tune on them. However, I always recommend doing a few other bolt-on modifications just to really help optimize the performance of the engine and help from a reliability standpoint to support the turbocharger and lower our EGTs and engine temperatures. Outside of tuning, that brings us to a cold air intake. The intake is helpful in just bringing more air to the turbocharger. The more air we can supply the turbocharger to, the more stress we can take off of it. And so this will help the turbocharger spool more quickly. You'll also get some small fuel economy benefits with it. You'll get an increased throttle response. But all in all, we're taking a little bit of stress off of the turbocharger, which improves turbocharger reliability and allows it to run a little bit cooler as well. And then once we talk about bringing more air into the engine, running higher boost levels, now we need to get the air out of the engine more quickly. That brings us to exhaust upgrades. I think we all know what the best exhaust upgrade is for all of these modern diesel engines, but I'm not gonna get into that topic here. And so I will say, from an exhaust upgrade standpoint, upgrading the downpipe and then upgrading the DPF or catback portion of the exhaust system is going to be the best thing that you can do to keep your truck's emissions intact. The downpipe is going to be the most important part just since it bolts directly up to the turbocharger. That's where most of the restriction and back pressure is going to build up. And so by upgrading the downpipe, we can reduce a lot of the back pressure in the exhaust, and that actually helps free up turbo spool. So that's going to allow the turbo to spool more freely and easily, which is going to reduce the amount of heat that it produces, which is going to significantly lower EGTs and engine temperatures. And then the catback portion of the exhaust is a little bit less important, but there still are some good back pressure reduction that we can get from that. And generally speaking, the catback part of the exhaust isn't super expensive to upgrade. And so that's a good thing to do if you're okay with your truck being a little bit louder, just to help reduce EGTs and back pressure within the exhaust system a little bit further. So those are really our three kind of performance-oriented modifications that we're going to talk about: tuning, an intake, and an exhaust system. And you're going to have yourself a pretty well set up 6.7 power stroke. The tuning is going to provide the big power gains, and then the intake and exhaust are going to combine for some reliability and efficiency improvements. And then the fourth thing that we're going to mention on the list is going to be an upgraded cold side charge pipe. The factory cold side charge pipe is plastic, and it is known to fail even at stock power levels, but almost a guarantee that it will fail once you start running higher boost pressures and add modifications to these engines. So you'll want to upgrade to a aluminum cold side charge pipe. This right here is our boosted performance cold side charge pipe. It fits all 2011 to 2024 6.7 power strokes, and it's available on Amazon or on our website at boostedperformance.com. And additionally, we have a lot of these other basic bolt-on modifications that you'll need as well. We have intake systems for 2011 to 2019 6.7 power strokes. So go ahead and check out Boosted Performance for all the upgrades you need for your 6.7 power stroke. That covers it for this video. If you appreciate the content, please click the like button, subscribe to our channel, and stay tuned for all the future content we have coming on the 6.7 power stroke.